to another vlog, Grace Emma Elegance. If you're new, consider subscribing to this channel. If you're coming back, you're most welcome. So to start with, oh, thank you so much for coming to watch my video. I really appreciate it. And as you can see from the title, today we are going to discuss about how to deal with narcissists. As you know, narcissists can be in so many ways. You can have a narcissist kid, you can have a narcissist auntie, you can have a narcissist partner, maybe boyfriend, husband, or wife, or yeah, or girlfriend, you know. And I just wanted to generalize it on how we can deal with this narcissist. To me, as I was doing my research, I noticed that even me one day, in one way or another, I have acted as a narcissist. And to start with, most of the narcissists, they react out of something, because you can't be a narcissist just like that, no. It's because you have your childhood traumas, you have a lot of stress, and you should control that. You should learn, whenever you're dealing with someone, you shouldn't be harsh on them, you shouldn't be in aim of hurting them and all that. And when it comes to parents, sometimes they ask you for something, and whenever you tell them you don't have, they will act weirdly, sorry to say, like they will become mad, they will keep off and all that. But all the same, it's good to follow up with them and tell them, this is what is happening. I can't be able to come. I can't be able, if they want money, you can tell them, I can't be able to send you money right now. When it comes to aunts, most of the time you go, you meet them and they are like, you haven't been married. You haven't married yet. Or the best way to deal with them is just to tell them, chill. I haven't got someone. You don't have like to be rude when you're answering them. Just tell them, oh, bado sijapata mtu, na nikipata mtu nitawaletea. Wakikuuliza story ya watoi, because it happens so many times. You see, like right now my son is 5 years old, so you find them telling you, how ongezei mtoto mwingine, and such kind of things. How you deal with them? You tell them, I'm on a budget, and when that time comes, I'll work on it. If you're not married, you can tell them, when I get my man or my mbabas, I'm going to add another kid. Because some of them, they talk like that maybe because of the cultural issues. Like they believe you're there to give birth, you're there to keep on helping them. I'm not saying helping is bad, but you see, sometimes it becomes too much, and you're like, this is too much for me to handle. So how you do, you just be soft on them. You will never know what they are going through, because whenever there is a narcissistic reaction or any treatment, you just know the issue is not you. They have an issue. So it's good you be nice to them and you be kind to them, you know. For the kids who sometimes are narcissistic, you just have to watch them. Maybe they are on drugs or something, peer pressure and all that. And you just talk to them nicely, because you see, most of the time, whenever there is something bad happening or to people, what you can give them is your time and your care, your love and all that. And that way you will be able to handle it. If it becomes so much, you don't have to dwell there. Just keep off from the narcissists, from the narcissist and all that. And you will be able to handle them. This is an issue that is happening so much, and that's why I decided to share with you. And then you can even talk to your friends, or maybe a counselor, tell them to help you and all that. That is my experience, and that's why I decided to share with you, because I'm not the only one who have ever encountered this, who have ever done this. And I hope you've learned something. You know, it's all about positive vibes, enjoying life, having a good time, you know. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel.
Thank you so much for watching my video, for turning on that notification bell so that every time I upload a new video, you're able to be notified. What I ask from you is to subscribe to this channel. If you haven't, if you're a returning subscriber, you're most welcome. What I request number two is that you share this video, continue subscribing and spreading love with good intention. You will never know what the other person is going through, you know. I love you. See you in the next one.